स्टूडेंट्स क्लास 10 चैप्टर 8 स्टैटिस्टिक्स अरिथमेटिक मीन ग्रुप्ड फ्रीक्वेंसी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन। हियर वी आर गोइंग टू सी द ग्रुप्ड फ्रीक्वेंसी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन। फॉर एग्जांपल इट इज रेटेड एज 10 टू 20 पॉइंट्स बाय अ स्टूडेंट्स। 8 स्टूडेंट्स हैव टेकन 10 टू 20 पॉइंट्स इन एथलेटिक्स एंड 20 टू 30 पॉइंट्स has taken 10 students and 30 to 40 points have taken 12 students like this. This is called a grouped frequency distribution. This data is called a grouped frequency distribution. First we want to find out what is the, see here the class interval is given 10 to 20. So we want to find out the mid value. First we want to find the mid value. Mid value, this is the upper class limit and then lower class limit. See, the upper class limit is here 20 and the lower class limit is 10. So we have to add that upper class limit UCL plus lower class limit LCL divided by 2. Sum of the upper and lower class. For example, 20 plus 10 is equal to 30 divided by 2 is equal to 15. That is the mid value. So UCL and LCL here. So this is the mid value, right? Here UCL and LCL are upper class limit and lower class limit. Here we have three different methods to find the arithmetic mean for ungrouped frequency distribution. The first method is direct method. And then the second one is assumed mean method. And then third one is step deviation method. By using any one of this method to find the arithmetic mean for a grouped frequency distribution, let's see one by one. First one is a direct method. See, in a direct method, the class interval, without the class interval, the data are given like this 10, 20, 30, 40, like this. And then the students are given 10, 7, 2, 5 like this. By using this data, by directly just multiplying these two, and directly we can able to find out the arithmetic mean. Arithmetic mean we denoted that x bar. So summation of f into x divided by summation f is the formula to find the arithmetic mean for grouped frequency distribution. Grouped frequency distribution. Here f is the frequency of the data. Next we see the assumed mean method. Here assumed means our own, we can choose the any number, that is it's called assumed. Our side we have assuming that I'm going to get a centum, I'm going to get a 90 marks like this. That is our assumption, right? So assumed value, let me take it as here as A. So to find the arithmetic mean for a grouped frequency distribution is x bar is equal to assumed value plus summation frequency into the deviation divided by summation f. Here where d, the deviation d is equal to x minus a, that is the given value, that is the mid value of that given data, minus assumed value, that is the deviation d. So the formula is x bar is equal to a plus summation fd divided by summation f. Next we see the step deviation method. Step deviation is nothing but the as what we are using in the assumed mean method. We have using the same formula, that is x bar. Additionally we are using the common term c. So x bar is equal to a plus summation f d divided by summation f, summation f d divided by summation f into c. Here where d, the deviation d is equal to x minus a in assumed mean method. Here we have the common value, so divide by c. So the d is equal to x minus a divide by c is the formula. Here we take it as the common value as the class interval, the width of the class interval as the c common value, right? So step deviation method, x bar is equal to a plus summation f d divide by summation f into c, where d is equal to x minus a, that is the class interval mid value minus assumed value divided by the width of the class interval.